Hello everyone, so this is the video tutorial for lab 2. So there are three objectives of lab 2. The first is to implement a 3-bit adder using full adder and verify its functionality using the test bed. The second objective is to implement a 3x3 binary multiplier using the full adder and verify its functionality using test bench. The third objective is to test the functionality of both on the Zygo board, that is your FPGA board, using the remote access. For this we will be using the PIUI. So let's implement the first objective first. So let's get started and create a new project. Click on next, write the project name. So click on the RTL project, and we don't need to specify sources at this time. Click on next. We have to create the first file. So first I will be creating the top module of the adder. Next. We don't need to specify the constraint file right now. We will be doing it later. Next. So in the boards, I have to select the Zygo board. So in the board, you can search for Zygo and select Zygo Z710. You can click on next and finally on finish. So before entering the port name and their bit, let's see how to implement this 3-bit adder. So this is the circuit diagram for 3-bit adder. I will be using 3 full adder. So for the 3-bit addition, I need 2 inputs of 3-bit each. So my A and B are the inputs, and my sum can maximum go up to the 4 bits. So I will be needing a sum output of 4 bit. So I have to make use of full adder to implement the same. So we have to connect this full adder in this cascaded fashion. For the first full adder, the third input of the will be the carry in of this full adder will be 1 tick B0, that is grounded, and then I will be propagating the carry of the in the subsequent full adder. So finally I will be getting all the 4 bits of my sum. To implement the full adder, so you must be knowing about the truth table and the expression to implement the full adder. Let me revisit this. So for the sum expression, I will be needing A XOR B XOR C, and for the carry expression, it is A XOR B and C, and I have to OR this compute with A and B, right? So now let's implement it. So first I have to define the port of the top module of the adder. So for this I need two inputs of 3-bit each. So I have to select on bus 2 down to 0. So this is again a plus. This is 2 down to 0, and finally the sum. This is my output, and the width of the output is a 4-bit, so that is 3 down to 0. So we can click on OK. So next we need to define the functionality of the full adder. So I need to make a module which will be defining the functionality of full adder. So let's add a design source. Next, and create a file. I am naming it full adder FA. Next, I can click on finish. So a full adder have 3 1-bit input. So I am taking it A, B and C, and 2 output. This is sum and carry. Sum and carry to selected as output, right? I can click on OK. Next thing, I need to define the functionality of full adder. Assign sum A XOR B XOR C. represent KD. XOR B. And C. We have to OR with A and B, right? So these are the expression for sum and carry. I can save this module. So now in the top module, I have to instantiate the full adder module 3 times and make the connection as I showed you in the circuit diagram of the 3-bit adder. So for the first thing, so for the first instance, for the, so I am using the named association here. For the third input, that is a C in input. For the very first adder, first full adder, I need to supply only the grounded connection. So I'm just giving one tick D0. So the sum output of this can directly be assigned to the LSB bit of the sum. That is a sum 0. So the carry output needs to be propagated to the next full adder. For this, I am using a wire type, wire C1, so I have to define a wire here, right? Next is the second instantiation. So one thing I need to point out here, that whenever you use the name of the instance as same as the previous or any instance in the module, so Vivado will throw you an error. So the name of each and every instance must be unique in the same module. So here in the C input, I will be propagating the carry from the last stage, and that was C1. Sum I can directly assign to the first bit of sum. And carry I again need to propagate to the third full adder. So I am making use of the C2 wire tree. So this is the last instance. LSB. In the carry, I will be using the carry from the last stage, that was C2. So I can assign to this sum, second bit of sum. Carry will be assigned to the MSB of the sum. This is sum 3. So you can see an error here. Yeah, so this error is about the bracket which we have not used for closing this bracket, and you can see it highlighted here, right? So now we can save the top module, and once you save it, all the instances should come in the hierarchy, as you can see here, IN1, IN2 and IN3. So let's cross verify our connections to the circuit diagram. So this was our circuit diagram for the first one, A0 and B0. The carry in was grounded, so the sum was assigned to the S0. The carry out is propagated to the carry in of the next full adder. And for the next full adder, we have provided input as A1 and B1, and the sum is assigned to S1. Next, the carry is again propagated to the last full adder. And this A2 and B2 is the input, and sum is assigned to S2, and carry out is assigned to S3. So that's what we have done. For the first four letter A0 and B0, carry is dropped, sum is assigned to sum 0 and carry is propagated to the next stage and so on. Right. Next we need to check the functionality of this design of the tau adder. For this I will be writing a test bench. Now to make a test bench, you can click on add sources and then you can click on add or create simulation sources. Next, we have to create a file. Let me call it as adder underscore test bench. Okay, so next I can click on finish. So a test bench does not contains any input or output code, so you can directly click on OK. Right, now where to find this test bench? You can go to the simulation sources, and in the simulation sources you can go to this adder underscore. So there are some steps that we need to perform in a test bench. So first is to define the variable, that is a step one. So all the input codes of the top module will get transformed here as a register. So we had two ports of 3-bit each. So I'm making two registers A and B, which are of again 3 bits. The next is the output. The output is will be transformed through the wire. So my output was a 4-bit. So this is my wire sum. This is my step one. To define the variables. Second part is to instantiate the design in the test, that is your duck. So I have to instantiate top underscore adder. See the instance name is PD1. So this is A, B, right. So this is a step two. Instantiate dot. So dot is stands for design window text. Third part is to initialize the variables which we have defined. So for A, I need to write. I'm initializing it with a 0 value. Right. So this is your step 3. Initialize reg. Initialize the registers. And the last step is to provide the stimulus. Change the, or I should say, change the stimulus to check the functionality. So after 5 simulation time units, I am assigning A to 3-bit, let's say 001. And I am assigning B as, let's say, 1. This is a 3-bit 111, right? Okay. Next, I will be providing this as 101, then the B6, and let's see. This is 111 and 118. So this is the step 4. This is your stimulus. Right. So now I can save it. So essentially what should happen is, at time equals to 0, my A and B should get the values as 0, 0, and this both 0 and 0 after 5 simulation time units. So when I talk about the simulation time units, as in the time scale I have written 1 nanosecond, so my time scale unit will be 1 nanosecond and the precision will be 1 picosecond, right? So the time will run in nanosecond. So after 5 nanosecond, A will get the value 1, B will get the value 7, So now after the 5 seconds, these 5 seconds will be added to the earlier 5 seconds. So it will be a cumulative effect. So at 10 nanoseconds, I will get A as 5 and B as 6, right? So now we will check the functionality whether our design is working fine or not. For that, we have to run the simulation, right? So next we need to run the simulation to check whether our design is working fine or not. So let's run the simulation. Run simulation, run behavioral simulation. So you can zoom fit it to see, watch it clearly. Okay, so let me change the radix. So if I change the radix to one sign decimal, I can see 1 plus 7 is 8, so this is correct. 5 plus 6 is 11, again this is correct, and 7 plus 7 is 14. So our design is functionally correct. So that was all about your part 1 of the lab to design and implement a 3-bit adder using full adder. So we have made use of 3 adders and we have implemented a 3-bit adder and checked this functionality using the test bench. So in the next part, we will be checking how to check the functionality on the hardware using the Zygo board, right? So let's do that.